United Kingdom donates to climate preparedness in vulnerable countries. The UK has announced a contribution of £20 million to support developing nations in preparing for and responding to disasters, especially climate-related events. £12 million of the funding will be channeled to charities that provide a rapid response to crises like droughts and floods via the START network, comprised of over 58 agencies across five continents. The other £8 million will go to the UK Centre for Disaster Protection to help at-risk countries mitigate humanitarian emergencies brought on by climate change and pandemics. The funding is a part of a £48 million climate support package the UK government announced earlier in 2021. The United Kingdom is a laureate of the Shining World Leadership for Caring Award, Shining World Wise Leadership Award, and Shining World Leadership Awards for Protection, Animal Protection, and Kindness. Our appreciation, United Kingdom and all nations whose policies as well as their actions invest in saving lives and protecting our climate. May we remember that caring for our planet and all beings is the spot-on solution for long-lasting climate stability and peace. In heaven's grace.
United States investigating COVID vaccines' side effects in youth. The United States Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, or CDC, is currently examining an abnormal number of heart muscle inflammation, or myocarditis and pericarditis, or inflammation of the heart's outer lining cases among young people who received the second dose of either the Pfizer-BioNTech or Moderna vaccines. The 277 cases were among teenagers and young adults, most of whom were male. Thank you, CDC, for helping to ensure the safety of the citizens of the United States by investigating the side effects of these COVID vaccines. In the grace of the providence, may the pandemic soon subside as we enter the vegan golden era of peace and good health.
Japanese government report recommends vegan protein to reduce emissions. The Japanese government recently released a white paper on the environment that advocates the adoption of meat alternatives such as soy and other plant-based proteins to limit greenhouse gas, or GHG releases. The report noted that people need to consider the carbon footprint of their lifestyles and highlighted the large amount of GHG emissions caused by the various segments of the meat industry. It underscored that burping cows release significant amounts of methane, as well as the production and transportation of their feed results in high levels of carbon dioxide emissions. Japan is a Shining World Leadership Awards for Compassion, Generosity and Animal Protection Laureate. Way to go, Japan, on your recommendation that people re-examine their lifestyles and eat vegan protein products to help lessen emissions. In the wisdom of the Buddha, may all governments around the world heed your wise advice and move towards a plant-based future.
United States researchers develop method to recover phosphate from water. A team led by scientists at Northwestern University in the United States has created a way to extract phosphate pollution from water, which is currently causing algae blooms and plant overgrowth in water bodies, thus negatively affecting other aquatic life. Their technique uses a porous, reusable membrane that is coated with nanostructures that effectively capture the mineral from contaminated water and then release it when required. Apart from cleaning the world's waterways, their technology could also help to create another source of phosphate for fertilizers, which underpin the world's agricultural systems, yet is a finite resource with a dwindling supply. Kudos, Northwestern University researchers and all involved, for your tool to help recycle phosphate from waterways. In the blessings of heaven, may your nanomembrane successfully scale up for large applications as we clean and care for our beautiful planet.
Mother and son feed thousands in need in India during pandemic. The duo were inspired by an opportunity to feed around 100 people through a donation of a caring customer given in May 2020 during a COVID-19 lockdown. Seeing that the effects of the pandemic had pushed so many more people into poverty, Hina Mandavia and her son Harsh, who own and run the Harsh Thali and Paratha's vegetarian restaurant in Mumbai, decided to continue feeding more people. With support from over 11 countries, the fundraising campaign they started was able to generate nearly $30,000. From that, the restaurant has been able to distribute over 26,000 meals, 62,000 chapatis. 7,000 sweets and 1,000 immunity booster balls to individuals in need since last year. Mom and son plan to continue their altruistic endeavor. Three cheers, Nina and Hart Mandavia, as well as the restaurant team, for your noble efforts to feed those in need. May the spiritual people of India continue to be nourished and the pandemic soon end as we adopt the life-saving vegan diet. In God's mercy.
Supreme Master Qinghai thankfully present the Shining World Compassion Award to Hina and Harsh Madhavia, plus $15,000 to humbly further this benevolent work, with much love and best wishes.
Women's CrossFit competition in Germany sees three vegan athletes on top. Lydia Bartosiewicz, Katarina Isele, and Lisa Eble were the top three athletes in the recent No Bull CrossFit Games. They each attribute their success and performance boost to a plant-based lifestyle. Additionally, all three said their love for the animals was a motivation for making the benevolent transition. Miss Isele stated that she had considered going vegan for some time and felt great after making the change. Ms. Bartosiewicz reported that she switched to plant-based eating to address a long-standing injury, and because of the transforming love she felt after petting a calf, she now visits cows every weekend. Ms. Eble said that there are sufficient plant-based proteins to allow her to be competitively fit. Our admiration, Lydia Bartosiewicz, Katarina Isele, and Lisa Eble, for your achievements. We pray for your continued glory and success to inspire more athletes to go plant-based in God's love.
Israel officially becomes the first country in the world to ban fur sales. Scheduled to go into effect at the end of 2021, the ban, which has some limited exceptions, was first proposed in October 2020 by Israel's Ministry of Environment Protection, Her Excellency Gila Gamriel. She stated, "There is no need and no justification for the use of fur in the garment industry." The minister further shared, "I call on all countries to join us, and together we will show benevolence and act kindly towards animals. It is estimated that over 100 million animals are cruelly killed annually to supply fur to the fashion industry." Israel is a Shining World Leadership Awards for Humanitarianism and Caring recipient, as well as a Shining World Caring Leadership Award and Shining World Leadership Award for Peace Laureate. Such incredibly positive news, Israel. In heaven's immeasurable grace, may your shining example lead the way for all governments to adopt a total ban on harming animals, thus assuring in our vegan world.